Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. I do have a new product to show you here on the channel. I'm pretty excited for this one. This is something I specifically went out, contacted this company. They are sponsoring this video in the end, but I'm excited for this. This is called the Remo Plus. It's a door camera. And what's different about this device and why I thought this was important to show you guys is it actually goes over the door frame, and so it's not stealable. And that's something that I've really been personally struggling with, adding the different cameras here in my home. You know, inside my home, I don't feel too bad about it, but outside, getting those exterior cameras, I wanted to get something that people couldn't steal. So let's get this device opened up. I'll show you what's inside. And then of course, I'm going to show you how to set it up. And throughout, I'll be giving you little review points as we go through the setup of this device. So let's get going. The Remo Plus is a smart home camera that is $200 US from remoplus.co. You can head to that website, pick one of these up. Now, the features that you're going to find here and what really drew me to this is a couple of things actually. The push notifications, the night vision capability, you have cloud recording and they're in HD quality here. You also have a weatherproof device, and that's relatively important for something that is generally going to hang out outside your door. Now on top of that, you're obviously never going to have this device stolen, and that's one of the biggest things to me. It does have the motion sensor and it does send you those push notifications, which is great. So inside the box though, you're going to get a quick start guide from Remo Plus. It is actually quite useful. You get 3D batteries, and then you also get an Allen key and some mounting screws, and I'll explain those in a bit. There's really not much to those. Now, on top of that, once you pull out the camera out of the box, it does have some wrapping over it to protect it. And then here's your camera. Now, what you can see is it's kind of a two-sided device, and the top is really, really thin because that's what actually physically goes over your door. There's actually a parallel cable, if you remember old computers, in that top piece that goes over your door. Now, turning the device over, there's a status button, it's called, up at the top, and you can see that you can pull the back off. That's where the batteries actually go. On top, you have two screws that you can actually pull off with the Allen key. And then once you pull those two screws out, you can actually shrink the space there between the two components, and this makes it easy for you to fit it to your door. Once you fit it to your door, then you can go ahead and put the screws back in the device. And then on top of that, on the top of the device are those two holes right there, and those are your mounting screw holes. So if you wanted to actually secure this to the top of your door, you could do so through that. Now you have to open up the back here and put in the three batteries. That's a factory reset button. So if you did have trouble, I never did, but if you did, you could use that button to factory reset the device. Now you can see the LEDs turn on as soon as you get the batteries in there, and it's waiting for connection now. So we're going to switch over to the iPhone app. You could get this on Android as well. It's the Remo Plus camera app. Now, of course, like most devices, it has a pretty standard sign up process. You have to change your country up in the top right, and then you sign up and you choose your device from there. So I chose Doorcam and had to select my time zone. From there, it's asking you to actually go to the Wi-Fi settings in your phone. Now that the device is powered on, it's actually broadcasting a Wi-Fi signal for you to connect to. So switching over to my iPhone settings here, I just go into Wi-Fi, and there you can see Doorcam. And once I connect to that, then I go through a very, very simple process of coming back into the app, choosing the Wi-Fi network that I want it to connect to, putting in my network password, and then it sits and it connects for a couple of seconds. Once that's done, we're good to go basically. Now the Remo Plus is actually connected to my home network. it's working already. So this is when you would actually put it over your door frame. And I'm just going to skip ahead a day here to show you. This is what your screen ends up looking like as you've missed motion detection at your door, or you've been there at your door, or you've answered some of the calls. So going into one of those videos, you can actually see it instantly downloads onto your phone, and then you can actually watch the playback. From there, if you'd like, you can do a number of things with these videos. Now you can see right here, I just tapped on the screen, I could download this video. You can see that I can pause the video, I can share it, and I can delete it. Now I'll show you how those work in a little bit here, but keep in mind that is the camera completely in the dark. Now going back into the device screen, I can change the name of the device here, and then I have to hit the little check mark over to the right. Once I do that, it renames my device. So if you did have multiple, that would do that for you. I can trigger on what's called live view. And what they do warn you about is that it will drain the battery very quickly. And live view won't work until you have that next event on your camera. So you just have to go and move basically near your camera. Once you do that, you can view your Remo Plus cam on a live view, and yeah, the battery's draining relatively quickly because it's always on now. Once you do that and you tap on start live view, this is what you get. And this is the same thing you get when you get a notification from the app that someone's at your door. You get an accept or decline. And once you tap on accept, here's what you get. So the left icon is the mute mic, so you could actually mute it. Right now you can actually speak directly into your phone, and it is being sent through your camera. Now there's a little slider there that is the volume coming through your phone. You can mute that speaker as well if you'd like, and then you can end the interaction. So fully functioning two-way audio there that you can have with anyone who shows up at your door. Now, once you have these, again, here's that answered motion. So because I went into the app there and I quote unquote answered someone at the door, even though I just started the live view, here you go. You can see that I can download the clip, I can share it, and I could delete it if I'd like. Now, going back into the menu and back into the device itself, I want to show you some more of the settings here. So you can see the video quality. I can change it depending on how much network speed you have in your home. Best, average, or low. I can change the save videos to cloud feature. What that means is you wouldn't actually upload the videos to their cloud service. Remo Plus has a cloud service here. There is no storage on the device, so it is basically, at that point, all you would get is the motion push notifications and the ability to interact with someone through the camera, and that is a free service. So the motion push notifications, you can lower how many of those you're going to get. That basically changes how often that triggers. You can change the motion sensitivity, which changes how much the camera is looking for motion, and so you will get more triggers based off of that if you go on a higher setting. There is, of course, night mode, which you could turn off if you wanted to. I don't know why you would ever change it from auto, but they do give you that option. Now, a little bit about the subscription here. How do you save your motion videos? We saw that setting, but it does cost $3 per month or $30 per year. You get unlimited storage, and the videos are stored for 30 days. So that's actually an incredibly reasonable subscription service for them to keep your videos. Now, of course, in the application, if I wanted to, in the devices section, I could hit the plus button down at the bottom to add another door cam, or they have other devices here. A couple more features I just want to show you in the application. There is the viewers component here. You can go into that. If you had multiple phones set up, you would have multiple people. You can, of course, change the photo or change the name of those people in the application, similar to the way you did it with the device. And then you can go to the cloud section, which is actually how you subscribe to the Remo Plus cloud service. you see, I do have a standard 30-day trial when I get this device. Now, on top of that, there's the account page, which there's not a lot to do there, and the about page, which gives you the ability to change your time zone and see some information in terms of firmware on your device. And finally, there's the support page, which I've already shown you a little bit about, but it is actually a really good support page. I was surprised with how much content is there. Now, just so you can see the device and the clarity behind, this is how good the camera looks with just a little bit of light around it. So you can see the clarity that you're getting from this camera. It is really good, and even the low light stuff is pretty good as well. So all in all, this is a really good camera. I've enjoyed it. I'm going to go ahead and sign up for the subscription service myself because it is reasonable. So there you have it, guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.